up and then click on it and I'll make the most money and then I'll click on yours. Copyright fraud, YouTube has excellent systems for if you rip off a video and upload it or you rip off music. Facebook really doesn't have any of those right now. There are people building absolutely massive Facebook video pages off the back of ripping videos off YouTube all day long. So if you want to build a Facebook page, I'm not saying you should do this, but people are doing it right now. Finally, influencer networks. All of those basic white girl accounts are run by young teenage boys. They have networks of them, and they're just making money hand over fist by having millions of Twitter followers. So the point is, on the internet, no one knows you're a dog. No one really knows anything. So be inspired by these ideas to think, what can I do to get a competitive advantage? This is a typical growth engine for an app, but it's basically the same for any product. Firstly, there's awareness. So someone tells you about what an app they're working on, and then you download it. Then you activate it. Then you should share it with your friends, ideally. And then because of that, there's more awareness. So I'm going to focus mainly on the first awareness, because it's the hardest part. But I find most companies fail on the share part. So how do you get your customers to do the work for you? It's not an optional thing. If 1,000 people download your app, 900 of them will never use it after the first week. Multiple studies have shown. So it's really hard to get 100 users. So if you don't have them sharing with their friends, it's going to be a massive uphill task. So if you're doing software as a service, the best thing to do is give someone 3 months free if they recommend 5 friends. So get them to do the work and then you'll get a massive reply. CUME is a credible tool for capturing emails for people. So if they are hovering their mouse and about to leave their site, they get a pop-up. The two best pop-ups for conversion are if you're e-commerce and selling something, 10% off if you join our newsletter. If you don't have something to sell, you can do, we've created a white paper on the 10 problems everyone has with our industry or 10 things you're doing wrong in our industry. Give us your email and we'll send it to you. If you do written content, there's also this widget right here. This will enable people to share a lot easier with one click. CUME requires no code. It's a WordPress widget you just plug in. This is the secret formula to getting returning users. So it's known as the hook model. So firstly, there's a trigger. So someone tells you about an app or site. Then you go and use it. There's a variable reward where you feel good about it. Then there's an investment that you create a profile. Then there's an internal trigger in your head and you go back to the site. So some of you today were a bit bored at work and you decided to go on Facebook. So what happened there? Facebook didn't have to advertise you to bring you back to the site. There was an internal hook in your head which hooked you back to Facebook. We don't go on Facebook and Pinterest because we like the content. We go because the content might be good. So we just have to check to see if there's anything on there worth having. That's the internal hook. So whatever your product is, you've got to have that internal hook. If you're a news site, is there a big story that people will come back and be checking on? If you're a blogger, are you blogging every day so people think, I'll go and see if they've written anything today? When you join LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, you might have noticed your email gets completely blown up until you turn off those notifications. The reason they do this is a lot of people sign up and then forget they've signed up and these notifications bring them back to the site. You can do it too for whatever you're working on. This is Mandrill by MailChimp. So if someone has not signed in for a month, you can automatically send them an email.